Welcome back, guys. Back on the Lake Logi server. And I'm just clearing a space for our new shop. I mentioned last episode that that's what we're going to do, and that is what I'm going to do. I have selected this spot because basically it's nice and flat, and I like that. It's pretty central to the portal, so people are going to see it. It's right next to the bridge. And also, when we bring villagers through, it's also going to be nice and easy to put them in there. I'm not going to have to goof around with them too much. So basically, I'm just going to clear a bit of area. There is a bit of redstone in this build, so I think I'm going to have to dig down, I believe, 5 blocks? Yeah. And I'm going to try to put it under the bridge, the redstone. It's going to be on one side, mostly, so might put that under the bridge, and then once I get that all dug out, I'll okay, GG me. I've dug out the area for the redstone, and I did it in the wrong spot. So now I gotta fill this back in. So that happened. Okay, so this time before I dig out, I've actually laid out the area for the shop we're gonna do. So I don't mess it up this time. Also, in creative, I kind of have my redstone shooting out this way. If I do it this way, I can fit it. So I think I'm gonna try that. So maybe a mistake, I don't know. Should be fine. Shouldn't make too much of a difference. So again, I will go digging that out, and you got a bit more of a better idea of just the way the shop's gonna, well, the size of the shop, I guess. So let me go dig this out, and then we can play with some redstone. Okay, guys, I've cleared out the space that we need, and I've placed our chest, which is right, it's in line with the center of our shop, but it's actually at the back of the store a little bit, and we've got an item sorter here, and right now, it's not sorting anything. It's gonna be dirt, just for example's sake. But you can see that we have a pulse that extends out, and now that's dropped down because this has probably dropped to 41 and 4. Boom, 41 and 4. That's gonna be diamonds. We're gonna put diamonds in there. So yeah, that's the plan. And then we need a big pulse extender. So to do that, we're gonna create a micro pulse extender, because if we try and do the big one straight away, we don't get enough, because these pull through really, really fast. So it just kind of makes a clock, so we need to make a small one first, and then if we put some dirt in here, let's put one dirt quickly, and we can see, yep, it made it all the way around, and then it created a little pulse. So now we're going to basically extend this by 14, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and then we want redstone dust here, and we're going to come back the other way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And then now, if we put a piece of dirt in here, we should see this thing make it all the way. Oh no, it doesn't quite make it all the way. Oh yes, nope. No, it's not going to do it. And I'm thinking that's because I actually moved this over one block from what I did in creative, so the pulse might just be a little bit shorter than it was, than I was expecting, but it should only be a couple of seconds, so it won't make too much difference. So let's try this again. So let's put a piece of dirt in here, and we should see it get all the way. Yes. Okay. No. Oh, man. Okay, so what I did was, instead of taking the repeater out this way and bringing it around, which was creating a little bit extra redstone dust, I've just shortened that. I'm hoping that difference, because comparators recognize signal strength. So if you have, right here, the signal strength is 15. Here it's 14, 13. So I think that's why we weren't quite reaching it. So now it should give us the 14. So let's try this again. Come on, fingers crossed. Yes, 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 yes. Okay, excellent. All right, and this gives us about 25 seconds of pulse, which is good, but it's not quite enough. And it's pretty much the maximum that I can get out of this. There we go, it's dying out now. So what I can do, and this worked in creative, so I'm hoping it works right now, is we're going to build a second one like this. So once this pulse dies out, we will still get a 15 signal strength, and so we should essentially double our pulse by putting a second one here like so. So if this works, it worked in creative. Oh, jeepers. Yeah, there we go. So hopefully it works now. Servers and stuff always a bit funny with lag and ticks and all that jazz. So now we should be getting, I think it worked at about 45 seconds. So that's powering up there. Okay, good. Okay, and in 25 seconds or so, we're gonna see this one die out, but this one should stay on. Come on. Any second. What you gonna do? And there we go, this one's dying out. Yes, and this one stays on. Okay, and our output, these are staying on, and these are really close to where we need it to be, right? So then, we can take a comparator. I don't have one of those. Our chest is here. The wall is going to be one, two, three, four. Here's our wall, so we need it to come up here. Oh, that's a fake. Okay. Let's just double check that. One, two, three, four. Here's the wall. In line with this. I went up too far. So, yep, here. Okay, so this is where we want our torch tower, basically, to go, which will power our pistons upstairs. So now, all we need to do is run some redstone into some blocks. And I don't want to use... I have some stone. Okay, that'll do for now. Okay, so let's take this signal here, and we want it to go to here, here. I'm gonna need a repeater. Right, let me go get a repeater. Okay guys, if we jump down here, you can see what we've done. We've just basically taken the redstone signal out of there, up into this torch tower, which will then come up and bring us power to the very roof of our shop. So now once we are through a chest in here, a piece of dirt in here, we should see this top torch turn off. There we go. Which will unpower the pistons. I plan on using this, and then 50 seconds later, can you work out what I'm doing? Have you quite worked it out yet? Alright, so the next part is... we start building the shop, close this up, because this is done. Okay guys, so I already placed that in the wrong spot. GG. So basically, this is a little bit of the design, so we're just gonna come around like this. And like this on both of these here. And I've just got the red nether brick, which is freaking gorgeous. I don't care what anybody says. Okay, let's have a look there. There we go. Yeah, I just think it's absolutely stunning, if I'm being honest. And it's really hard to use, I find, because it's just so damn bright. But it works well with quartz, I think, and so that's kind of the design we're going to go with here. Okay, so now we can actually kind of, now that we've got this wall kind of doing its thing, we can kind of actually have a look and see what we're going to be doing. So let's get to bed. Can I sleep? Come on, man. That looks pretty nighty to me. Come on. Here we go. Don't want any creepers coming and messing up my stuff. So the plan is to be a little bit sneaky. We don't have any slime balls at the moment, so sticky pistons aren't really a thing right now. But normal pistons definitely are a thing, so let's craft up a couple of pistons real quick. Or at least just one piston. Yeah. I believe this. this is how you craft make a pistol. Okay, so basically what we're gonna do is we're gonna have a villager in each one of these. So there's gonna be like a little holding cell for it here, so he can't get out. I'm gonna just use dirt to finish explaining. So basically there'll be a holding cell here, and they won't be able to get out there, right? And then what we're gonna do is at this level, now we wanna go up another couple. Yeah, that's good. So he's gonna be basically standing here. Yeah, you'll see his head here. So what we want is a piston right here. This will be a sticky piston, keep that in mind. And then we're gonna need some of, I didn't bring any with me, okay. Silly me, that's fine. We're gonna need some of these. That was way too many, wow, okay. Yeah, so once there's blocks here as well, that'll actually form a proper window. And basically, this torch tower, we're gonna run redstone all the way along like this, right? And we'll just pretend that this is redstone making its way here, right? Which is gonna power that. So this is always gonna be closed. So here, you're gonna be able to buy emerald blocks, right? And then if you wanna trade with the villager, you're gonna have to throw in a piece of dirt here, which will turn this off, which will release that. Now, sticky piston obviously will pull this up. So once that's done, you can then trade with the villager. So essentially, to trade with the villager, it's gonna cost you a diamond. And I think that is the best thing I've ever thought of, if I'm being honest. I just thought that was the funniest thing I could do. So you've got 45 seconds, okay? And remember, we're gonna have more than one here. It will release all four, but there's just no way you could get around and do all the trading that you wanted to do in 45 seconds. If you can, I mean, plan it out, GG, go for gold. So basically the next step, I'm gonna keep building this up and try and get the, I'll get the sticky pistons and I'll get the rest of these walls done. And at the front section here, we're gonna have our three chests for emerald blocks, nether stars, and ender chests. So we'll keep on going with the design of this room and get it all built up, and then we'll come back once we've got a little bit more done. Okay guys, so I got one of the walls in and finished, and I think it looks awesome. Just gotta keep in mind that this will have a piston behind it, so we've gotta keep it kinda hidden, and there'll also be blocks behind it, but I'm not gonna put those there until I got the villager in place, otherwise I'm just gonna have to remove them anyway. I'm not 100% sure what to do with this back wall. When I designed it creative, these walls were just iron blocks, just to get the general shape. So what I'm thinking is the red stained glass behind there, and then just a couple of diagonal of the more of the red nether brick as little corner accents. Yeah, I think that looks quite good. This wall here, I'm just waiting on I don't have a lot of nether wart, so I'm just basically harvesting this as it grows and adding a few more blocks here and there. This wall is just going to mirror this one completely. I think what I'll do next is I'm just going to get something in for the flooring. I'm not too sure what to do. I think maybe just some slabs. I might try to do some clay. But for right now, right this very minute, I'm going to bed because it's like 3 a.m. I'm trying to get everything done before I leave in a couple of days. So yeah, this will probably be a bit of a tired work, I think, but I'm really, really loving how this is coming out so far. Like, I just think this red nether brick with quartz is just freaking gorgeous. So yeah, I'm really excited, and I cannot wait to wake up tomorrow and try to get this place finished. Sweet. Okay, boys and girls, we're back. It's nearly 24 hours later since the last cut, actually. I didn't get a chance to record. I did have a lot of downtime at work today, so I was able to get quite a bit done. You see, I've got these three guys lined up here. So this guy is Unbreaking 3 for 12. Hell yeah. His other trades aren't that great, if I remember correctly. Yeah, no, and Yeah, that's too great. You'll see I've got a lot of quartz in my inventory. That is because I was having a think, right? I said we're going to sell ender chests, but ender chests are pretty easy to come by, and we have like the ender farm anyway, so they're not really that big of a deal, but I have a lot of quartz, and quartz is quite painful, and I think it can be profitable, so we're going to throw quartz in our store as well. Next one, Luck of the Sea. No, that's not why he's here. He's here because of this. Looting 3 for 20 emeralds. That's a pretty good deal. Up back 2, pretty average. And then this guy here. No, that wasn't the one. Where are you? There, Fortune 3 for 16 emeralds. So these three are going to go in with our mending villager we've already got over at the shopping district. So let's go on through this noisy portal. And, I'll show you what I've got done here. It's nighttime. I don't want it to be nighttime. Okay, so you can kind of see the shop here. Oh my god, wow, rubber band. Okay, here's the shop. Yeah, it's coming along quite nicely, actually. I'm going to change these out because it's too red. I'm going to put quartz back there. Let's put this away in the chest inside and we'll have a look. So this is the front of the shop. It needs a roof. We're going to do that now. But this is the front of it, and basically I just built up all around here. I didn't go too hard with the red nether brick just because it's very bright, but I do love this block, and our villages, as we saw before. Go in there. This is functional. I just don't have enough diamonds, so we're gonna have to do that before the end of the episode. And I lowered this down, and I'll show you why. I lowered this down because now you kind of have to look up a little bit. You kind of have to look up at the very, very pretty... Hey? Why aren't you down? Well, we're going to go up and have a look at the redstone in a minute, so it doesn't matter. But yeah, you're going to have to look up at it, sort of everything, and I kind of like that. I like people having to come in here and look up to my wares. So this will fill this up, hopefully. Yay, I'm so good at math. This here is going to be nether stars. And then this here will be our emerald blocks. Let's go up and have a look at the redstone before we do too much of that, because that's clearly something ain't right. Let's grab some redstone while we're at it. We'll probably only need dust. Yeah, I don't know what's going on there. So that was definitely working earlier. Maybe I broke something earlier. Yeah, okay, right there, perfect, okay. Okay, nice, okay, GG. So, basically, yeah, I moved the torch tower, it was a bit wonky, and so I basically got that just here. I've left this open so you can see. This just torch towers up, and I'll put some more pillar here and cover that up completely. Once we're sort of done, let's try an ender pearl. Yay, we made it. I thought that was a creeper, it's just one of those stupid little endermites. Okay, so yeah, and then as you can see, very, very simple. The redstone just goes along here into this block, repeater into this block, and underneath both of these are our pistons. Which we don't even really need the block there, but I'm gonna put it there because symmetry. I did think about maybe doing it so when you activate that, we get some note block action going and have a bit of a tune. I'm not going to worry about that just yet, though. The other thing is this, we may also do a second layer as we find new things to sell and explore and do all that sort of stuff. But for right now, I think we're pretty much good to go with that. So let's just go down here and let's see this thing in action. Right now, it's still configured just a dirt box, which is a bit of a pain. Oh, that's not how that works. But yeah, so if we put a dirt block in here, you should hear it. There we go. And these raise up freaking perfectly. And then, of course, 50 or 45 seconds later, these will close up. So yeah, I'm really, really happy with how this is coming along. Next step is to throw a roof on here and get some lighting in. So I think first thing we're just going to slab over the top. And then we're gonna play around with some lighting and see what we can come up with. So I'm gonna get to that right now. I'm gonna get some quartz and then I'm gonna get to that. Okay, I'll be back. Okay, so I've started putting the roof in and I'm loving it. if I'm being honest. I think it looks amazing. But when I get to this section here, I'm kind of thinking, I think I want to add some color, or I want to do something with this. I don't want to just slab it. Maybe I have to. I'm not too sure. I'm going to go ahead and just put slab over the top and enclose it, basically. And see how it looks. If it looks crap, then we'll go. I don't really have enough of the nether brick to really do too much, I don't think. Maybe I can use it around some lights in the middle, so we might try that. So I'm going to go ahead and just grab these and then slab. One too many. And then, yeah, finish slabbing this. And I really like this too. It kind of looks like the doors are open, which is really cool. Alright, yeah, so I'm going to go up and finish slabbing over the top of this, and then we'll play with some lighting and see if we can add some color to it. Okay, so that actually doesn't look too bad. I'm pretty happy with that. But we do want to add a couple of things, so we need some lights for one. So let's see how this looks. Can we just put that up there? Yeah, we can. Okay. That's not too bad so far. Okay. We don't get a lot of lighting here, but that's kind of cool. This is all spawn-proof anyway. Mobs can't spawn on slabs or stairs, so we're good there. We need to put a block in under here, because otherwise that's going to drive me crazy. That was a little latch I was using before. Latch? Hatch. Hatch is better. There we go. So that's a lot better. Color. Dunno. Maybe we just pop these out and try to put in some of the some of this red nether brick here. Is that? Let's pillar off a bit, because that's gonna be really frustrating otherwise. Yep. That'll do. Let's grab our pickaxe back. What if we just do these 8 here? See how that looks. Already, I think. No? Let's just see how it looks there. Yeah, that's not too bad, actually. Yeah, that's not too bad. I'd like if maybe. It's very flat. If we drop it down one, would that work? Yeah. I already think that's better. Yeah, I do think that's a lot better. Let's get rid of this. Go there. Break that. Okay, it's a bit dark in there, but I kind of like that. Yeah, look how good this looks. I'm so happy. I'm terrible at roofs. Roofs never work out for me. I don't mind this. This is pretty good, I think. Yeah, I'm just gonna say it. It's good. And look at the blue, like the bluish color that you kind of get with this. It's really cool. I really do love quartz, I'm not gonna lie. You can probably tell that by now. But yeah, I think this is looking absolutely freaking awesome. Alright, so the next step, get our inventory in here. So we can actually do that now. So we need to rename these. The prices. Now, prices. Yeah, we need one of these just there. Prices. We need one of these. One of these. And one of these. Now, here's my thinking, okay? If we make these one diamond each, that might sound like a lot. But, with the current system of one diamond to pay for the villagers, one diamond and two diamonds for two blocks, which gives you 18 emeralds, you can get a mending book. So essentially, you can get a mending book for three diamonds. So it may seem expensive, but actually it's a pretty sweet deal. We want to put an ender chest in here somewhere also. Do we want to just put it by the front door? Maybe in this gap here? Yeah, I think that'll work. We'll just do that there. Okay, so that's that one done. Now we need to pay for paid for? Rename. Okay, one for you. Get in there. Yeah. One for... Oh my god. Can I replace a thing in a damn thing? Yay! And you. Sweet. So is that name still? What? What? Did I put the wrong one in here? What the? One. That's another one. One. Diamond per block. Okay, that is definitely named. So let's pop that in there. And then we're pretty much just left with the sign. Yeah, pretty. Perfect. Okay. And now we need a sign here, which I'm not happy about because it's kind of horrendous. Maybe we can just pop it on the front here. Yeah, that works. Okay, so let's actually write on it. How's that sound? Good. Okay, so place one diamond in the chest to access trades. Thank you. Done. Okay, so now we actually need to get our villagers in here. This is gonna be fun. I seem to have lost a villager. Not sure how that's a thing, but I broke the minecart, he went through the portal, and then he wasn't in the other side. Oh, you sneaky monkey. Look at you. Get in that portal. You're so sneaky. Get in there. Has he done it? Did he do it? Alright, that's better. You may or may not have noticed before I started recording today, I actually went around and lit up everywhere I could. Now where is he going? Okay, he's here. Alright, sweet. Yeah, I went and lit up like all the way around there because I was just getting sick and tired of having creepers and zombies and everything chasing me everywhere. It was really making life difficult for me. Get on this one would be better. Yeah, nice work. Okay. Why did you not... There we go. Oh, that worked. Alright. And you're off. And what I did as well is I took the iron bar out and I blocked it off from the inside, so hopefully we won't break the minecart. Oh, sweet Jesus. That could have been horrible. Wow, okay. Yeah, that was what I did, and I nearly murdered him. Jeez. Okay, water bucket. Man, I can't believe that. That was crazy. Alright, get in the thing. Why are villagers always so difficult? Just go in your home. Yes, yes, yes. Keep going. Go in your home. Why is there no sea lantern there? Also, is my... Where do you think you're going, guy? Should be a sea lantern in the floor. Let's do that first. Why is there no sea lantern? I don't understand. Yeah, that's better. Oh, you're all the way over here now. Guy, you are just a pain in my butt right now. Alright, go, go, go. You're just gonna go in there all nice and smooth. There you go. There you go. There you go. Go. That is your forever home. You're staying there. A forever. Sweet. Done. Okay, we're gonna... Oh, sorry, zombie. We're gonna cover those up with some stairs, I think. Probably the way to go. Maybe we should make these stairs also. Probably. Let's find out. Yeah, I like it. Works for me. Sweet. Alright, perfect. Alright, so now I'll switch this rail over and we'll go to get the mending guy out of there, and then I'll come back once I've done that. Alright guys, we did it. We got all the villagers in place, and wow, we need a block there. Yes, is it the same on the other side? Maybe? What if we do that? That's... I can't even see through that gap. What is up with that? Oh, we're missing a stair there. Okay, that's interesting. So let's put this back here, and now the shop's complete. Let's go check that other side. Do we have blocks there? It's not even necessary, is it? No. Okay, let's go replace, take those away. We'll take this dirt away while we're at it. This is complete, guys. We're done. This didn't actually... I mean, it was a lot of work. But, I think it's been worth it. I really do like this store. I think it's come out really, really great. The thing we do need to do, very quickly, is we need some signs. So people actually know what those villagers are selling. And we need to put the diamonds in there. And we need to put a bit more quartz in there. But I'll take care of that, I'll take care of that off camera. But as of right now, guys, if you're watching, the shop is open. We need one more. So yeah, go ham, guys. I will be coming back from Australia in 2 weeks. I've got 3 videos. This is the 3rd video. So by the time this actually goes out, I should be coming back from Australia. And then I'll be back to normal times. Alright guys, well, while we do, I'll put these signs up here. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you liked the video or liked the build, please give us a like. If you didn't like it, let me know. What didn't you like about it? And I'll try to improve on that where I can. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye!